Welcome back to yet another interesting session by Intellipaat, friends. So today in this video, we are going to talk about Informatica. And I hope that this is going to be helpful for you to understand what exactly it is. Let's begin then. So first of all, let's go through the agenda of today's video. So we are going to look at what is Informatica, followed by its components, then the working mechanism of the same. And then we are going to look at one of the case studies based on Informatica. And of course, a practical session dedicated to Informatica. And finally, career opportunities you can have in this particular field. Let's begin then. But before understanding what is Informatica, let us see why actually do we need Informatica. So today's competitive corporate world actually runs on business decisions that are data-driven for sure. And thus, there is a strong need for data integration tool that can actually enable organizations to achieve, let's say, faster, better, and more efficient data processing for quicker reporting needs. And due to this, ETL tools are actually seeing heightened adoption rates amongst the organizations around the world. And hence, Informatica is one such a tool that is popularly used across the world. Now let's talk about what exactly it is. So Informatica includes several products that mainly works for data integration. So Informatica Powercenter is a flagship in the portfolio. In general, you can also say that Informatica is used as synonymous for Informatica Powercenter. So Informatica is nothing but a data integration tool based on ETL architecture. Now it gathers data from various sources and then loads it into distinctive targets. It also provides data integration software and services for various businesses, industries, and government organizations. So these government organizations can again include like telecommunication, healthcare, financial, and insurance services. Now, Informatica is strong enough to handle huge volumes of structured and unstructured data, just like flat files, databases, log files, etc. Now, let us look at some of the components of Informatica. So, the image on the screen shows very clearly the architecture of Informatica. So, as you can see that it includes various components, just like Informatica domain, repository services, admin console, source and target system, etc. So what are these components and actually how do they work? Let's see that. So first of all, we are going to talk about Informatica domain. Now it is an administrative unit consisting of nodes and services. And then there are basically two types of services in the Informatica domain. The first one is service manager and then the application services. Now the service manager is actually used or responsible for authenticating or authorizing the logins, whereas the application service is responsible, or rather, it is responsible for running the application services. Now we have got repository service. So it actually maintains a connection between the clients and PowerCenter repository. So it's basically a multi-threaded process that fetches, inserts, and updates the metadata. And after that, we have reporting services. So these are actually responsible for handling the metadata and allowing other services to access the same. And then we have got integration services. So again, this is responsible for executing the tasks created in the Informatica tool. So as soon as a workflow is executed, the integration service gets the detail and executes it. So these are some of the important tools used in Informatica process. Now we are going to move on to the working mechanism of Informatica. So if I talk about working mechanism of Informatica, then the first step is extraction of data. Now during extraction, the desired data is identified and extracted from many different sources. And these can be simply either database systems or applications. However, it is not possible to identify the specific subset and it is again carried out in the later stages of the process only. Now once the data is extracted, it is transported to an intermediate system for further processing. Now, second step involves transformation. So based on the requirements, some transformation may take place during the transformation and execution phase. So through Informatica mappings, the necessary changes and updates of the data are made using these transformations. And then in the load phase, the data is loaded in the target. And after all the transformation, it is again transported to the target system for loading the data into the target system. And then if we talk about domains, then Informatica is used in various domains, just like banking, insurance, publications, and many more. So in banking, it is generally used to process large amount of data and then to verify inconsistencies in the data. And if I talk about insurance sector, then it is used to validate the information of claims and customers. And again, it is also used to migrate the data. And likewise, it is used in different sectors for different purposes. Now that we know what is Informatica and how does it work, let us look at the case study of Western Union. So Western Union actually helps loved ones to stay connected by moving money around the globe. So the 160-year-old company is evolving its business model using data strategy. Now this will enable or rather help in the expansion of digital products, growth of web and mobile channels, and a more personalized online customer experience. So in 2013, Western Union processed more than 29 transactions per second on average, which generated a significant amount of structured and unstructured data. Now this data must be integrated from diverse sources such as legacy, mobile and online data. So the company actually needs to cost effectively deal with the data complexity while simultaneously scaling access, storage and processing, right? So in short, the company faces increasing competitive pressure from emerging technology players. So in order to fulfill, rather increase the business insights, Western Union used data platform based on Hadoop and Informatica Big Data Edition. So using Informatica, business insights and efficiency increase in rapid pace in Western Union. So this is how it actually helped Western Union to increase its business insights. And after this, let us look at a demo video to understand how actually we can connect databases to Informatica and then access the tables. Let's begin then. So this is my screen for Powercenter 9.6.1. And you can see on your right hand side here, we have got this connection explorer. And so as the name suggests, here we can connect through the different database connections. Okay. Now here we have got another two options, right? So here the first one is to create the connection. And then another one is to select the connection. So first we are going to create the connection and then we'll look into the select connection. Okay, let's begin then. So let's click on the create connection over here. And I have to give name to my connection. So let me name it now. Okay, so just give me a name to it, rather to my connection. And I'm calling it first connection. And then you can also give a description to it, right? So, you know, when you are actually going to create multiple connections, that is when the description helps you to kind of differentiate. So I've just given the normal description. So then after this, on which machine your database is actually installed? So for me, it is localhost. So I'm going to keep it as it is. And then type. So here again, which database you want to connect. So I have got Oracle installed on my machine. So I'll select Oracle. Okay, so let me select that and then click on next. So now here again, you have to provide the schema name, something that you are going to use as a source and target. So for me, the schema is test. So I'll enter the password after giving the username. So test and then the password. Okay. And now in the connection string, if I talk about, so you have to give the host name again. So for me, it is again localhost. So I'll type it. And again here, this is 1521. So this is actually nothing but the port number for Oracle. So you must be aware of this port number of Oracle. And then we have got this SID. So for me, it is Express. So I'll write XE. And again, here in the connection string that you need to define in your database. So for me, again, it is XE. Now let's check whether this connection is proper or not. So we are just going to click on test connection. So see, it says that metadata or metadata connection successful. It also says that data access settings will be validated when connecting. That means when we connect to database and work on a specific table, then only the specific metadata or connection would be tested. But here, as of now, the schema connection has been done, right? And it'll be testing it later on, right? You got it. Whenever you are going to actually work on a specific table. So after we have created the connection, we'll just click on finish. and we are going to select connection now. So select the connection. So again here, we have selected the connection. So you just need to select this. So already we have got here, we call it domain localhost. Under that we have got databases, then Oracle, and then our first connection. Okay, so then we'll go to configure connections. And here, see again, you follow the same path like domain localhost, then databases, Oracle, and our first connection. Now you can also edit this first connection. You know, you can edit the details that you have already entered over there. See all the details that we entered. And also you can simply remove your connection from here. And if you want to copy this specific connection, then that is also possible from here. Now let's go back. So click OK again. OK. So now in this select connection, my first connection is up here. So this is how we create a connection and then select it. And now in this selection, which all tables are actually available under this selection. So for that, just double click on first connection. Okay. And then here is my schema, which is test has appeared. And again, in that, we have got all these many tables. You can check all these tables are over here, right? And then we have also got views and synonyms. So whatever is present in this schema, I can simply look into that. So from here, we can see all our tables, views and synonyms. And this is how you connect your database, select the database and then select the schema and access your tables. So I hope you guys have got a fair idea about it. Okay, so let's move ahead. And after this, ultimately, let's talk about the career that Informatica has got to offer you. So Informatica PowerCenter is actually being deployed by some of the biggest corporations, just like, you know, IBM, Accenture, and then there are other many big organizations with Informatica in place. So there's an insatiable demand, you can say, for Informatica professional. And once you complete this course, you can simply look for careers such as Informatica developer, coordinator, specialist, BI developer with Informatica, ETL technical manager, or Informatica business analyst, and many more. And then you can also see the average salary of Informatica developer in US, which is quite promising according to me. And after this, let's quickly go through what all we have learned today so far. So we saw what is Informatica and then its different components followed by its working mechanism. Then we saw a case study based on it and then of course some practical work and finally the career opportunities it has got for you. So after watching this video, if you also feel like you need to make your career into this particular domain, then not to worry, because Intellipaat provides a separate course on Informatica specially designed to gain expertise in core concepts of PowerCentral ETL and repository management. And with this, we come to the end of this video. Thank you so much guys for watching this and giving us your precious time. For any inquiry, feel free to contact us anytime. I hope the video was informative for you. Please like the video and if you have any doubts, comment below. We shall respond to it at the earliest. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel for more such informative videos. Do look out for other related videos in our playlist. For more detailed information, visit our website now. Have a great day and career ahead.